Hello everyone, I am here in Mandel Swiss Workshop, January 23rd. And I have the pleasure to be with EOS Costa Rica block producer, here with Edgar Fernandez first, hello, and Luis Diego Rojas. Thank you to be with us. So straight to the point, guys. Recently, EOS Costa Rica has joined the Core Plus working group by the EOS Network Foundation. And I will address with you, Edgar and Luis also, what is your contribution into this Core Plus working group?
Thanks, Patrick, for having us back on. I think taking a step back first, you know, what is Core Plus? What are these working groups and why were they put together by the EOS Network Foundation? First, as people in the ecosystem have now realized, the Network Foundation was put together to really try and accelerate the adoption of EOS.io and EOS Mainnet in the blockchain ecosystem, and taking a community standpoint of what needs to be done. And the first step to that is realizing what we have, what gaps exist, and what needs to be built in order to compete in a highly competitive and accelerating blockchain protocol market. So the first step of that is the creation of these working groups. The one you've mentioned, Core Plus, really is focusing on the software that runs and maintains the blockchain, the EOS.io blockchain protocol. So that's the core of everything we do, right? There's other ones like wallets, API, smart contracts, the Ethereum virtual machine integration as well. But the Core Plus one is really about what is needed for developers to run software on EOS Mainnet and other EOS.io sister chains. So that was the goal of Core Plus, identifying, recommending and prioritizing what is needed for the ENF to fund and impulse for the quick adoption and increased competitiveness of the EOS.io protocol. We are not, EOS Costa Rica is not part of the Core Plus. Core Plus was really the direct hire of the ENF of Zizen, or Europe Chain, which is a corporation incorporated in the European Union and already encompassed a lot of block producers that were active with a lot of experience in the ecosystem. We were identified by that group as a contributing party and also someone that can help them identify and deliver on some of the recommendations that are coming out of this working group.
Okay, because your experience, because your education mindset also. So now that's come to the topic. What are your contribution, current contribution maybe that you have already begun? Can you maybe unveil something about your current contribution or ongoing future contribution? Yeah.
Sure. Well, I think as identified already in the Core Plus Medium post, and I encourage the audience to check that out as well. We were identified as a group that can contribute in the training and education portion of the goals of Core Plus. So onboarding and bringing on new developers on smart contracts, connectivity, and dApp building for EOS.io and EOS Mainnet specifically. So that's what we were identified. You know, you'd have to ask that question to the Core Plus working group directly or ENF, why us? Well, I would say because we had a history already of evaluating the ecosystem, surveying what's there, seeing what gaps were needed in terms of onboarding a developer from the beginning to actually being able to deploy a smart contract or build a dApp. So we had some experience, especially with our guides, our multilingual guides for developers. And I think, you know, our conversations have really been focused on another way to adopt this protocol is by creating video tutorials that have been pretty successful part of the training and certification program that Block One had formally started, but that we could continue to add to that and improve that video tutorials that are needed to, you know, really onboard and grow the EOSIO ecosystem. So that's where, you know, as they mentioned, they've identified us as a possible group that can provide not only the training certifications and tutorials, but also the guides that are needed to bring a developer from zero to 60 on EOSIO.
Okay, perfect. I saw also Edenia update that you do every Friday.
Well, actually, the name of this initiative for this project is Update Friday, and it's because we're seeing every Friday as a day to give you updates on what we've been doing, at least in the open source projects or other stuff that is going on that is community based or of any interest for the community as well. So yeah, that's kind of us just telling the community about things that we've been working on during that during those 5 days of the week. And with this initiative, what we're trying to do is become more transparent in how we are allocating resources, how we are investing our time, our funds, if any, or any other type of resources needed for these projects. To just let you know how it all goes, how it's going, what we're being up to, and so maybe you noticed that one of these updates included this this particular tweet where Core Plus was sharing the news that they identified our company, our team, to provide some collaboration. So yeah, this is kind of the type of content that we're trying to engage with the community more, to be more transparent and more, and kind of just letting everyone know what we've been up to.
Yeah, because this is something that I see when I am in Twitter. I see your tweet coming. I classify that into the Discord server because there is a Bullish on EOS Discord server, like a knowledge base, where I try to classify. I encourage the people to classify. It's also to be a data source for MindWeb, the Pomelo grant that I have finished as you, round one, season one. A big shout out to you for your grant that you have achieved also. And yeah, I will put into the video description all the link on that. So that's a straight forward update indeed. I would absolutely have you. You were approached because you have this knowledge, this capability to express that in a way very academic, understandable at a high level, also bottom level. You have a lot of experience into the blockchain use case. So it's clear Core Plus, it's this working group for a better usability for the use of the network, indeed the tools for a better use. So
right. I mean, to add on to the last question, just to make clear, Edenia is our holding company. It's the larger company that that owns EOS Costa Rica as an operating brand, and it manages that community based on that. So that's where that name comes from. It's our parent company that's, you know, been focused in blockchain for close to a decade now, and it's also the legal entity that we have that runs EOS Costa Rica. So we're all employees for Edenia. That's where that name comes from.
You are employees of Edenia. Okay.
Right. We you know, it's just a coincidence that it has Eden in there as well.
Yes.
We like to joke that Dan Lerman kind of grabbed the name from us, but obviously that's not the case.
Very coincidence. Okay.
Yeah, big coincidence. It was, you know, it's been founded in 1987, so I think we got the name rights a little first. Anyways. On Core Plus, you know, we're one of many other teams that have been identified. I think the great insight of what's going on, you know, if I can kind of speak to that, is the collaboration that once again is happening that I haven't seen since, you know, the launch of mainnet, right? Since the Genesis block of all these teams, global teams coming together to work towards bettering and improving technology that hopefully will improve the lives of everyone globally. So, I mean, that is the biggest takeaway that people, either you're a token holder, a dApp user, or a community member should take away from this is like the collaboration, the global collaboration. We were lucky enough and honored to be one of them selected to try and contribute, and not the only one, right? I mean, there's many, many groups that are now contributing that have been identified not only by the Core Plus, but by the other working groups and the ENF in general, to really try to increase the speed, I would say, that EOS.io now has to start to catch up with other third generation smart contract protocols. So I think that's a great takeaway. Yeah, we're focused on the training and education side, but Core Plus is really focused on not only that, but smart contract tools, documentation for developers, how-to guides, business opportunities, yes. And really anything that's core to software running on EOS mainnet and EOS.io sister chains.
Makes sense with all the history that you have. And you have identified during this Core Plus that you are still into the, I would say it's very recent. Have you identified other synergy with, for example, API Plus or other working group?
Yeah, I would think the main coordination is to not overlap, right? To not duplicate any efforts. And the other working groups have identified teams like ourselves and others to help work and reach those goals. I think right now it's just really focused. And this from, you know, watching public videos that you can see of the ENF and working groups, which are available to everybody, really understanding what is priority, for EOS mainnet, and how does that overlap with a priority for, you know, Wax, Telos, Fio, and the other chains, Proton, that are you know, moving forward. So I think that's a great sign, right, of this coordination. You know, with the other working groups, at least in my experience, there's a clear boundary of what the focus is, mostly just to avoid duplicate. But then when you all come together, it's mostly making sure that we're prioritizing what's you know, there's probably over 100 recommendations that are going to come out of this effort, but we have to prioritize what's most important and what's most urgent. I would argue everything's important. Some things just are more urgent than others.
Yeah. And at end of this month, January, there are blueprints, blue papers, so that should be released. Are you in this writing of this blueprint, blue paper for Core Plus? Are you participating to this writing currently? January 23rd now, if we can.
I look forward to reading it when it's published, and I hope everybody finds that to be valuable. I'm sure it is. And I know that it's been a really global effort between all the members, not only of the Core Plus working group, under the leadership of Zizen, you know, Europe Chained, and all the block producers there working to produce that paper. And I'm sure that they're grabbing inputs from all the global teams to make sure it's the most coherent and inclusive recommendations and survey of the ecosystem as a whole. So I'm very excited to
We are all excited, I think, to see that coming. We need that. EOS Network Foundation is the catalyst. Clarion OS team with Dan Larimer is the development, innovation, where all the innovation are. And you have the EOS Network Foundation. This is this catalyst. They want to prioritize the things. And we need that. We have a lot of things on the table, and now we have to stabilize the things. And EOS Network Foundation is here. EOS Costa Rica with a foot in Core Plus. That's nice. You can have a foot indeed in a lot of working groups with all your experience. I see you in. You have to choose. You cannot be in every group, otherwise. I think you have so much things to do also with your blog producer, and all the education that you are participating. So I think we covered the most important points. I will put all the link into the video description, guys. So don't miss those article, Edenia article, Core Plus article, and other links that Luis, Diego, Horas will allows me to share with the community. And yeah, I think we have to, maybe, do you want to add something that I totally miss into this workshop breakdown on Core Plus that we can unveil for sure?
No, I would just thank you for your efforts. I think it's great to kind of, there's so much happening and so much information out there, and really focusing and providing that insight in the short content. And as you mentioned, organizing that in the Discord server as well. Just a sign of appreciation, Patrick, for inviting us today, and also for all this work that you're doing, trying to navigate around all this information and everything that's moving so quickly, not only in EOS, but in blockchain generally. So thanks again for having us on.
It's a pleasure to be with you guys. And that will be not the last time. I have no crystal ball. There are five other workshops this year, every 2 months. So the next one, March 23rd, I will certainly have you on once again to discuss about the evolution for you, for your team indeed. It's not just Core Plus. It's EOS Costa Rica. We want to cover Latin America. So thank you very much to be with
thank
me.
Thank you very much.
And see you again. Thank you very much. And
thank you.
Go EOS.
Go EOS. Thank you.